So much love, the dog.
You ain't really good.
Sex don't sleep when the lights are off.
Anxiety. We all feel it, but do we understand it? This is Can Explains Anxiety. Okay, so we've heard the word and maybe have a general idea about what it means, but what exactly is anxiety? We asked child psychiatrist Amy Gajaria.
It's a way that people feel. You can feel it in your body, you can feel it in your mind, but ultimately, like, anxiety is a feeling or an emotion.
And let's get one thing straight. Anxiety is normal. Everyone experiences it from time to time. Even top athletes like tennis star Naomi Osaka and big celebrities like Dwayne The Rock Johnson have spoken out about their experiences with anxiety. Anxiety is not automatically a bad thing. It helps humans survive in a world full of threats, and it prepares us for real potential dangers like crossing a busy street. It can also help us perform at our best. If we didn't feel some anxiety, we might not feel motivated enough to study for that big test or practice for our next volleyball tournament. It feels uncomfortable, but that discomfort is temporary. So what exactly is going on in the body when we feel anxiety? Anxiety activates something doctors call the autonomic nervous system, or the ANS. The ANS is a system that comes online automatically and regulates the body's function like heart rate or digestion. It's made up of two parts, the sympathetic nervous system, that's the one that controls the flight, fight, freeze response, and the parasympathetic nervous system, which is also called the rest and digest system. So because of how these systems respond to stress or threats, the body starts to experience certain things. Once your body identifies a threat, hormones including adrenaline and cortisol are released. Those hormones can start to trigger physical symptoms, like a faster heartbeat to get more blood flowing to give you a burst of energy, shallow and fast breathing to get more oxygen to your blood, blurred vision to focus on the threat and block out distractions, feeling worried, not being able to concentrate on things unrelated to the threat, and even stomach issues like nausea or vomiting. That unpleasant reaction is a side effect of cortisol, which can irritate our stomach. Anxiety is part of our body's way of preparing itself to fight off and/or escape danger. So, imagine you're walking through the woods and you think you see a bear. Your body will snap into attention and prepare you to fight, freeze, or run away as a way to stay safe. Most of the time, we aren't in life-threatening situations, but our body doesn't know the difference. That's why we feel anxiety before an exam or a presentation, even though those things can't physically hurt us like a bear can. If the systems are working properly, once the threat is gone, the body should go back to working normally and any discomfort should go away. If feelings of anxiety don't go away, that could be a sign of an anxiety disorder. That's when the symptoms of anxiety affect your day-to-day life for an extended period of time.
Is your social anxiety bad enough to be a disorder?
If you're struggling with anxiety or think you might have an anxiety disorder, talk about it with someone you trust, like a parent or a school guidance counselor. And you don't need to feel embarrassed by your feelings. Anxiety and anxiety disorders can be managed. In the short term, one thing we can all do to help with anxious feelings is take a pause and do a quick breathing exercise. Dr. Gajaria says this helps because
it kind of takes you out of that flight or fight reflex and out of that sympathetic nervous system response and helps you and your body realize that you're safe and you're not facing a threat. The most important thing with taking a deep breath is to make sure you're breathing into your belly and not into your chest.
Why don't you join me in a breathing exercise right now? Yeah, I needed that. That's it for Can Explains. For CBC Kids News, I'm Isabelle MacNeil.